Hello, I'm Neeraj, your expert advisor from Luminous. Today we will tell you how to check the condition of the inverter battery, and this requires an expert. Please do not do it yourself at home. And if you want to get the condition of your battery checked, please contact Luminous Expert Service Facility. Equipment required to check the battery is a hydrometer, multimeter, and thermometer. Battery should be completely charged for the checker. Before you check the battery, please make sure that the battery is charged for 10 to 12 hours with a good inverter or a charger. Disconnect the battery from the inverter while charging and make sure it has no load. Now, first of all, please check two things about the asset. Look at the float indicators and try to find out the asset level. Usually, in all the cells of a good battery, the asset level is almost the same. Open the vent plug or float indicator to check the color of the asset. In a good battery, asset is usually colorless. If the asset color is brown or black, it means the battery has corrosion and may decay soon. Now check the voltage with multimeter. This will tell you how low the voltage is. Check the battery voltage with multimeter. When there is no load on the battery voltage should be over 11.9. If the voltage is less than 10, it means there is a problem in the battery. Now, if the battery is giving you less voltage, that means the specific gravity of any cell is less or a cell is producing less voltage. Let's see how to check the specific gravity. To check the specific gravity of every cell, dip the hydrometer in different cells. In a good battery, the acid level should be in the range of 1.240 plus minus 0.01. For a correct reading, check the temperature of the acid with a thermometer and set the acid gravity at 27 degrees Celsius with the help of a temperature correction table. If the gravity of every cell is in the right range, it means that there is no problem of gravity in battery cells. One important thing, low gravity can also be if the battery is not fully charged. This can be rectified by charging the battery for 10 to 12 hours with an external charger. The gravity level will be fixed. Even if this does not help, then follow the process told here. If the voltage is low even when the specific gravity is fine, then we need to check which cell is producing less voltage. Set the multimeter on DC. Connect the positive wire of the multimeter on the positive terminal of the battery and the negative wire on the cell next to the positive terminal. Voltage of the first cell should be around 1.6 volt. We will decide about this cell in the last stage. Remember, the voltage for a lead acid battery in a good condition should be around 2 volts. If the voltage is far less than 2 volts, it indicates that the cell has some problem. After checking the voltage for first cell, check the voltage of the second cell. Dip the positive wire in the first cell and the negative wire in the second cell. Make sure that the probe of the multimeter is just slightly dipped in the cell. Likewise, check the voltage of all other cells. If any cell shows a voltage below 2 volt, it means that the cell is producing less voltage and affecting the total voltage of the battery. While checking the sixth and the last cell, you will find the reading around 0.35 volts. The reading of the first cell was around 1.6 volts. Total of the last six cell and the first cell will be considered as the reading for the first one. If the voltage and the gravity of every cell is fine, but still the voltage is less, in that case, attach a small inverter and check the load for a 100 watt bulb. With the same process, check the voltage of the other cells as well using a multimeter, as sometimes due to some manufacturing defect, the battery shows current voltage without load, but a defect is only seen when the load is added. Remember, to get the battery checkup done by an expert, do not try it yourself.